Ben Abitangelo. In October 2012, I was part of a 13-man Indigenous squad that toured India. We knew it was going to be a blast. We knew it was going to be hot and sweaty. We knew the food was going to be tough to handle, but we had no idea it was going to turn out like this. Day one, check it out.
We're all here and we're all ready to go.
This is a bunch of black fellas getting on a plane to go to Mumbai and play cricket for 2 weeks. In which case, we're supposed to be learning something, both as a management team and as players. It's going to be interesting. There are 12 Indigenous cricketers. We have two management teams. We've got to make sure that everyone gets up out of bed early in the morning, that the bus is ready for us to go to where we need to go to, and that everyone's got what they need to make sure that they can play good cricket each day, including tomorrow morning at 8 o'clock. That Sunday that's gone for about 35 hours for some of us. It'll be challenging, but then that's what this tour is really all about. It's about what professional sportsmen need to do and how they need to do it to make sure that they perform at their peak on a regular basis. Important thing for us is to get the team on the field, to get rid of some of those cobwebs, to relax into the cricket. It'll be an important marker as to how the boys go tomorrow, as to how the program ticks over for the next couple of weeks.
Hits you when you're at the airport at 1 o'clock in the morning and it seems like it's peak hour. Not sure, you know, what their bedtime schedules are over there, but when we walked out of that airport and there was probably, you know, a good 5,000, 6,000, 7,000 people standing around at 1:30 in the morning, you start to think, you know, what have we got ourselves into? And it only gets more explosive from then onwards.
You are right now at airport. Now I'm taking you all to the bus. Then from bus we will go to Diplomat Hotel, which is in Kulaba. So you're going to travel with me. I'm going to harass you all, guys.
India, that's finest. There's car horns everywhere. Boys, how are you?
Yes.
Keep it tight.
This is mad. There's people all over the shop. It's like 1 o'clock in the morning, and it's like you know, midday in Sydney.
Mate, I'm all over this Hindi. Namaste, Chola. Let's go.
What's happening?
Tomorrow I'm again coming in the morning over here to the Diplomat Hotel, and I'm taking all the guys to the CCI.
Yeah.
No, half are going to Delhi and half are going to this thing, CCI.
They're here to learn, they're here to practice their cricket skills, and they're here to learn from the Indian culture. Cross-cultural cricket learning has been the theme of the Global Cricket School. And that's something we want these young Aussies to go through and take back something to their country in terms of an experience and share it with people. I think I'm ready to call it an evening. Yeah.
India, welcome.
Look, it's chaos for the eyes. It's just there's something happening in every square inch of the place you look. Look at that. That's just a you know, that's a magnificent piece of scenery, that is.
And you can see the same sort of, you know, landscape, seascape in many other places, but a little something about it that says it's Mumbai.
The thing that I'm worried about is that water. You've got to think about every time you use it. You know, I thought to myself last night, I've forgotten how many times you actually just use water, you know, and...
It's scary now.
It is a bit scary.
You know, you just soon quickly learn the do's and don'ts. You don't drink out of a shower water at the ground, you don't, which I've done, and I've been taken down. You always wash your hands. It's just part of everyday living over there. And if you tick those little boxes, you're more than likely going to be okay. But yeah, I guess going over to India sometimes, if you get a bit of a bug, well, that's just all part of touring. But yeah, I can count the last 10, 12 times I've been there, I've been fine. You actually get used to it, I think. When you haven't actually been to India, you don't actually realise how crowded it can be and how many people you can get in the one place at the one time. And, you know, when you've got 1.3 billion people, India grows the size of Australia every single year, 22 million people it grows. When you've got festivals on like Diwali, you know, the immersion of Ganesh, it's just that incredible population and that crowded population.
It's a scary thing that so many people live in such a small space. We're up on our A game, straight up. We've got a game against CCI, the Cricket Club of India, and going to be a tough call, I reckon, you know, pulling up after a long trip like that, but I think the boys got it in.
Under 19s was quite tough. We're on the back of the bus and in traffic jams and stuff. Obviously, when you're with the Indian Premier League, they can clear the roads for you. So you got two different ends of the spectrum there. It's obviously great to have a close-knit family on tour. You know, when you tour India for 2 months, it's a long, long time away from home. It's the same as touring anywhere else in the world. But in India, just because it's so hot and it's so crowded and you know, it's humid and all those things that I mentioned, you've got to make sure that you're nice and close to your friends that are on tour, but also too, I've made a lot of friends through the Indian cricket team. And as a change, you know, you just go out to an Indian restaurant or you catch up with the guys from the other side and chill out with them for a while too, because that just balances out the aspect as well.
We rocked up at about 2 o'clock in the morning, got to our hotel room. We were up at 6 o'clock in the morning and we were warming up at about 7:30 at the ground, ready to play at about 8:15. So it was a pretty frantic, say 48 hours, leaving Melbourne. First time of touchdown in India for most of the guys, and then bang, we're playing cricket.
They're ambassadors for Australia. Cricketers always are, because cricket is such an obsession here. And Indians will be so happy to talk and chat to them and find out their own personal histories, but also talking about cricket generally in Australia. Mumbai is not Australia in all sorts of ways. But most importantly, you guys are here and as part of a long tradition of touring Indigenous cricket teams. And this has been going on now for well over 100 years. When you're meeting people here, they'll be keen to talk to you. Cricket is an obsession here. People here will know more about Australian cricket than Australians know about Australian cricket. This is a place that has three 24-hour cricket TV stations, so you can watch cricket at any time of the day or night. It's really just to promote a positive image of Australia. And I mean, they'll do that by playing cricket, just by talking to people, and also be part of that extending the knowledge of Indigenous Australia to Indians, and we find generally that Indians are really quite interested in the whole concept of Indigenous Australians and the various aspects of the culture.
It's a great venue to have a great team playing, and CCI is probably India's number one premier club team to play against an Indigenous tour which is visiting our shores for the first time. Very historic day, and it's a day that on which a lot of foundations are going to be built going forward. First game and first loss for the Australian Indigenous team.
Man, I couldn't believe, like, they had some good batters.
Yeah, that
real good players.
That right-hander, that full like beamed in the net.
Going around with the Indigenous guys, having a good time, giving them a taste of the Indian culture and the Indian cricket.
Thanks, mate. Yeah, nice. Well done. Good game. You know, just the heat itself is a real challenge.
I thought the bowler shot, given too much room, swing, and they just got away with it and played it better. As the spins came on, it got a bit tougher, but you can only get a bit better. So I think each step, each game at a time, we grow a little bit better.
It's absolutely fascinating, enthralling to have such a young lot of hungry guys here coming to do something and be part of a cricketing revolution. If you want, Umesh will take you. You can buy it now only. Yeah. I'll get the car.
Okay.
You have Umesh's number.
Vida was a fantastic person. Someone who put the amount of effort in that she did to ensure that, you know, our tour went well, for the amount of money that she was earning each day. It's a credit to her, and it's the hours that we work and, you know, the rates and the benefits that we get. Kavita was doing 12, 13, 14 hour days, travelling to work, travelling home from work, getting a couple of hours sleep and coming back all for a few dollars a day. You can judge and think how she lives, but it's, you know, it's nothing until you see it, I think.
Where I'm staying now, it's with my mom, and we are five sisters. So now, right now, we are three sisters and one my mom. And my other house is like a big joint family. There are three brothers. Then my big ma, and 8 grandsons are there, you can say, and 3 couples, like my 3 brothers and their 3 wives.
Did you like the hotel?
Yeah, the hotel was fine. I mean, I would like 5 star, but you know, sometimes you got to. Yeah, I spoke to Sachin about that, and just a little bit of adjustment with the food.
Okay.
But otherwise, you know.
You didn't like the food? Aage chahiye. Bhaiya ji. Acha bhaada hai kya?
It's not we didn't like the food. It's just that it would be nice if we were able to get maybe some bacon and some sausages to go with the eggs.
Okay.
We had toast and baked beans. That was all okay. I liked the rice cakes myself with the lentil sauce. That was good with the coconut chutney. But these guys like their bacon and eggs with sausage.
Yeah, in the hotel or over here?
Hotel.
In the hotel. Okay.
So I think we're going to do a community visit and go and, you know, play a bit of cricket with a few underprivileged kids. And then I think we're meeting Julia Gillard later, which should be pretty cool.
The Prime Minister will arrive at 8:30. So a representative from the High Commission is going to hand over some sporting equipment to Magic Bus.
Yeah. Okay.
And at that point, the kids are going to break up and they're going to play their version of a 2020 cricket match.
Uh-huh. Big bash in Delhi. Get down.
Yeah.
We are working in a Magic Bus as a training and monitoring officer, and these children, they are working, they are from Kusumpur village, and we are working age group 7 to 14 children. These are marginalized children. They are studying, some of children they are studying and some of drop out, they never going to school, and we are working in a 3 main impact area: education, gender and health and hygiene. Our main aim is that the children get education in school. We are working on them.
It's not It's not about, you know, who's got the worst conditions, but I think it's important to reflect on the fact that, you know, our boys on this tour have family that live in conditions which are very similar. I know I do. You know, the Prime Minister of Australia has just turned up. Should I take my hat off?
As we know in Australia that the combination of sport and education really does change lives. So do you want to say a bit about what you're doing?
Thank you, Prime Minister. I'd like to acknowledge the traditional owners of Australia. These are the people that we come from, our community, our families. Can I introduce Ben Abantangelo, who's from Victoria? This is Darcy Short from Northern Territory. Hello. Can I introduce Dylan Fuller, who's also from the Northern Territory? And Josh Layla from New South Wales.
Nice to meet you.
On behalf of the guys, I'd like to present you with a shirt.
Thank you very much.
What a mic, so there you go. All you do. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Also, the name of my electorate.
Oh, how good is that? How good is that?
But now, last match.
Yes.
Tell us the story.
Unfortunately, yesterday the boys went down on the last ball.
So meeting Julia was very overwhelming. I got so overwhelmed that when I shook her hand, I accidentally patted her on the back, and something I look back and I laugh at a little bit now, but I sort of maybe regret it, and it might have been the wrong thing to do. But yeah, it was a special moment to meet the person with the highest amount of responsibility in your country, and the way she conducts herself was you know, something definitely to look up to.
It's very confronting to know that you're over there getting, you know, a whole trip pretty much paid for, and you're being looked after, and to know that, you know, there's a massive amount of people in that country that struggle day to day just to survive, and it definitely made us all, you know, appreciate, you know, what we've got.
Yeah. Well done. Excellent.
It is just such a huge population, and there's just so many people that need help. It's just really mind staggering.
Okay, Charlie. See this one, that one house.
Yeah, Kavita, that's an interesting story. She's from the Koli community, which is the original inhabitants of the city of Bombay of the Seven Islands. And they've been here before the Portuguese came, before all of us came and settled, and they were a fishing community, and they've been here for, I presume, at least 100 generations.
Basically, this is a place where middle class people are staying, and over here there are many people from many communities like Sindhis, Gujaratis, Marathis, Kolis, but this place is basically belong to the Koli communities. I'm taking to my place. Road, please.
These are the small temples. You will get in every lane, you will get a temple over here.
So you will be now meeting my family. Now that one is my house where I'm taking. This is the seaside which I stay. This is the sea where we stay basically. We want to see the show, ocean show. This is my house, you can say. See, all my families are there, upper ones. My big brother, my bhabis, and my small brother, and all my grandsons are there. Not mine. This is a big family. Around 25 people are there in the family. And me dadala boli magashi phone. The house is over here, it's only of 800 square feet. But in that one room, there are basically, you can say, 8 to 10 people who are staying in that small room, you can say.
And
traveling isn't an issue normally, but when you travel, you accommodate that with quite a bit of rest as well. That hasn't been the case so far for us. So we got in at, I think, 2:45, two nights ago. And then up at 6 yesterday, to bed last night at about 12:30 after dinner, and then up this morning at 6 again. So hopefully after this next flight, we'll have a couple of days in Pune to relax.
Touring definitely involves a lot of travelling. It sort of felt like we were in a pinball machine, you know, for most of the tour. It'd be very tough to play at the highest level and do that amount of travelling. Looking back, I don't think we could have, you know, continued on with that for another week or two without, you know, getting run down or sick. It is something that is very tough to get used to.
It's real hectic. It's good fun though. As long as we don't crash, it's good fun.
I came in, there was 6 overs out on 68, number 68, and first ball just tried to bowl line and length, ended up getting a snick, and Aaron Muir caught it. Second one I just tried to chuck outside off, and the bloke played at it and just squat it and got a catch. Third wicket was pretty much exactly the same thing. You always got to be confident. If you're not confident, you're going to go for runs.
Nakwa to me, Dakwa. Just coordinate with Nitin to see if all the rooms are booked up and everything is in order. Anything else from your side? Okay. You can just go over the checklist again, see that everything's okay. We'll talk again. Okay. Life, like cricket, is about cross-cultural learning. So it's the same principles that apply to cricket apply to life here.
The first religion in India is cricket. The second religion in India is cricket, and the third religion in India is cricket. Everything pretty much after that comes a good fourth. They want to see it, they want to touch it, they want to experience it. You can move mountains with the word cricket in this country. It's quite funny in many respects.
When'd you win, Pat?
Oh, Aaron's lost his bats. Gone somewhere, not sure where yet.
Yesterday we played a game. So last night we locked our kids away. Come in this morning, open my bags, no bats. So now we've got to solve the problem, which is either buy a bat or get someone to come see you with a couple of bats, which could happen both ways, so we'll see how we go.
I've still got $8,000 rupees and I've still got like $400.
Bats the main thing really, isn't it, as a batter.
The community in India, there's a lot of people who are on the lower standard who want to play on the higher standard. So for them, if they want to pick up a bat, I wouldn't be surprised. And I don't find it more of a crime, it's more of a passion, because when I was growing up, I would steal some chocolates and stuff like that because I wouldn't afford to buy it.
Yeah, I lost the bat. It's pretty good, isn't it? Left back home, but I don't know if it's... Yeah. What can you do? You know, I'm lucky enough that I can just go to my bag. I've got a couple of others, they're not as good, but... they'd probably stick with the one shitty bat for their whole life sort of thing, so... I hope it serves them well. I hope they move on to bigger and better places with it. That'd be great. Real good result.
I don't use it very well anyway, so.
Maska chaska dena do. This is a small shop where people, small kids, have their stuff. When I was just 3 months old, she used to take care of because my mom used to go for selling the fish. So at that period, my mom, just because of me, my mom was not able to go. So I used to come in this house when I was very small. She used to take care of me since from 3 months when I was till the time.
Aayi tu kiti varshachi astana mala 3 mahinyachi na? 3 mahinyachi te? Till now
she is taking care of me. So she is also like my mom. Selling these rotis for 10 rupees over here to different in the houses of the people. The Indian women are strong women. Even there is no necessity of the guys, you can say. And as you are saying, we are not having the guys in our house at all. Only girls power are working over here.
Having not known much about Australian culture, we were really looking forward to meeting them and interacting with them and trying to understand where they come from, because there's a lot of similarities between the tribes of India. and the Aboriginals from Australia. So we wanted to know where the connect actually is and if indeed there is a connect.
Now, the Indigenous people are, I guess, are very astute at picking up skills for ball sports like rugby league and Australian rules football back home. And it's an opportunity for Cricket Australia to try and tap into that talent pool and hopefully deliver some baggy green caps, as Steve was saying, to a couple of the boys, hopefully, that are here tonight. So hopefully we can get knee-deep in the Indian culture over the next few weeks.
My shoes are off. I'm joining in. Let's have the team up. Come on, guys. Everyone, please. Let's come. Show off some Aussie
come
culture.
On, Josh. Come on, Josh.
It's sort of like a dream where you're treated like absolute gods, when really we are a lot. Most of us are, you know, average Joes, but over there, you know, we do feel, you know, pretty special.
The traffic in India is really hectic, and all the drivers, they just have incredible peripheral vision.
There's obviously a lot of traffic and a lot of people. It's definitely a busier city than Canberra, where I'm residing at the moment.
The traffic's just unorganised, or just chaos, really. That's the only way to describe it.
If you can drive here, you can drive anywhere in the world.
They're crazy, all they do is beep the horns, driving on the wrong side of the road, but yeah. No crashes.
There's a lot of horns. I'm thinking of disconnecting my horn when I get home.